Okay, let's talk about the lung volumes and capacity. Actually, lung volumes are important parameters in respiratory physiology and clinical practice. So if you are an anesthesiologist or pulmonologist, for example, you have to have a good knowledge about lung volumes and capacities. Okay, so now let's imagine you are a good person, a friend of mine, and I'm asking you to take a normal tidal volume or a normal regular breath. If you are relaxed and took your regular breath, this is the tidal volume, the normal volume that we breathe involuntarily all the time. Okay, it's about 500 cc. Now imagine at the end of your inspiration, I asked you to take more inspiration to inflate your lung as much as you can. The added volume to the tidal volume, okay, this is the inspiratory reserve volume, which is the added volume to the already taken tidal volume, the inspiratory reserve volume. Now, at the end of expiration, if I ask you to expirate more air, to deflate your lung as much as you can, the exhaled volume is the expiratory reserve volume in this case. So the normal volume, the tidal volume, if I ask you to take more volume to inflate your lung as much as possible, this is the inspiratory reserve volume, which is about 3000 cc. The tidal volume is 500 mL or cc. The inspiratory reserve volume is 3000 cc. If you at the end of expiration I ask you to expirate more, okay, as much as you can, this is the expiratory reserve volume. So it is a reserve, it is a مخزون انت بتقدر تاخده او تطلعه. So this is expiratory reserve volume. At the end of maximum expiration, you can, there will be still certain volume in the lung, okay, and this is the residual volume. The lung will not be deflated fully, there will still will be, okay, a residual volume, a residual volume in the lung. Now this is the lung volumes. Now what about the capacities? The capacities are the addition of more than one volume. So if we add the inspiratory reserve volume to the tidal volume to the expiratory reserve volume, this is the vital capacity, okay? If you add the residual volume to it, this is the total lung capacity. So the total lung capacity is the whole volume that the lung can have, which is the residual volume and the expiratory reserve volume and the tidal volume and the inspiratory reserve volume. The vital capacity is the maximum expiration after the maximum inspiration. So the addition of this 500 cc, okay, the tidal volume with the inspiratory reserve volume, 3000 cc, okay, and the expiratory reserve volume, which is about 1100 cc, this is the vital capacity. Now how much tidal volume? 500 cc. The inspiratory reserve volume, 3000 cc. The expiratory reserve volume, 1000 cc, okay, and the residual volume 1200 cc or mil approximately. So the functional residual capacity is the addition of the expiratory reserve volume and the residual volume, which is very important, the concept of the functional residual capacity. At the end of your expiration, the volume at the lung is the functional residual capacity, which is the addition of the expiratory reserve volume to the residual volume. The residual volume, from the name, it's the volume that is will stay at the lung no matter how much you expire, okay? So expiratory reserve volume plus the residual volume is the functional residual capacity. Why is it important, very important in anesthesiology? Because when you anesthetize the patient and the patient now is in apnea, the only volume that will remain in his lung is the functional residual capacity. And the presence of high volume functional residual capacity by pre-oxygenation will give you more time to manipulate the airway of your patient, okay? Actually, the normal lung volumes can be calculated by the spirometer, but the residual volume will stay in the lung, so you can't calculated by the spirometer. You need special material or gases تحسب هاي الكميه، لانه انت مهما عملت اكسبيريشن راح يضل في ريزيدوال فوليوم، ما بتقدرش بالسبيرومتر تحسبها. بدك مثلا هيليوم فور اكزامبل، يو نيد نيتروجين واش اوت تكنيك اور بلاثيسموغرافي اوكي تو calculate the residual volume. Now let's move to the functional residual capacity. What are the factors that can affect the functional residual capacity? As I've mentioned, the functional residual capacity is the addition of capacity to the volume and the residual volume. The functional residual capacity can be affected by anything that can push the lung upward and close the alveoli so that the functional residual capacity will be decreased. For example, obesity. Obesity significantly affect the functional residual capacity, decrease the functional residual capacity. Abdominal masses, for example, ascites will decrease the functional residual capacity. The posture of the patient. If the patient is in supine position or in a prone position, for example, the diaphragm will be pushed against the lung and this will decrease the functional residual capacity. The lithotomy position will decrease the functional residual capacity. Lung diseases, restrictive lung disease, will decrease the elasticity of the lung and push it. So the restrictive lung disease will decrease the functional residual capacity. So all the previously mentioned conditions will decrease the functional residual capacity. وبالتالي إذا أنت خدرت patient, if you anesthetize a patient with a decreased functional residual capacity, you have to pay an attention to his oxygen saturation because he will rapidly be desaturated as a result of apnea. What are the things that may increase the functional residual capacity? For example, the length of the patient, the height of the patient will increase the functional residual capacity. The male patients have 10% more functional residual capacity than the females. Okay, so those are the factors that decrease and increases the functional residual capacity. And there are, of course, many other factors, but I want to mention. Now, the last concept I want to talk about is the closing capacity. Closing capacity. Now, this is the alveoli, okay? Alveoli. And this is the lung tissues around the alveoli. Now, at the expiration, the volume will get out from there, okay, to the large airways and to be exhaled from the body. This is at the expiration. Now, what keeps this alveoli open is the presence of surfactant at the wall of the alveoli and the traction of the material or the tissues around the alveoli. This is what keep the alveoli open. Okay, so if you exhale a lot and you exhale, for example, to reach the expiratory reserve volumes, you exhale to this extent. Okay, if you exhale to this extent, the alveoli will close. Okay, because there will be a very low volume of gases in this alveoli and the tendency of the alveoli will be toward the closure and towards, let's say, having atelectasis. The volume at which the alveoli will start to close in the dependent area of the lung is the closing capacity, And actually, at the young adult patient, the closing capacity will be well below the functional residual capacity. So if the patient take a normal breath and expirate a normal breath, the alveoli will not close. If the patient expirate more than his normal breath, if he paid an effort to expirate more, for example, for expiratory reserve volume, the alveoli will start to have closure, okay? So this is the closing capacity will be here, for example, or here, or here. With age, the tissue around the alveoli, as you can see here, will be destructed, okay? And it will not support the alveoli that much as when he was young, for example. So the patient alveoli will be closed at smaller volumes. تمام. فبهاي المرحلة لما الواحد يصير بعمر أكبر الألفيولاي راح تسكر وهو يعني حتى at the normal tidal volume. تمام. يعني هو لسه والله عم بيعمل اكسبيريشن. احنا حكينا بالوضع الطبيعي اليونج بيشنت لما يعمل اكسبيريشن اكثر من المعتاد والفي لاي فوليوم كثير يفضى, ببلش ايش؟ ببلش يصير عنده كلوزنج كاباسيتي. بس مع العمر الكلوزنج كاباسيتي بتطلع لفوق, بصير البيشنت حتى وهو ديورنج النورمال اكسبيريشن تبعه بتلاقي الالفيولاي سكرت لانه ما فيش تراكشن حواليها تو سبورت ذا الالفيولاي. سو كلوزنج كاباسيتي وذ ايج ويل انكريز, ذا فانكشنال ريزيدوال كاباسيتي ويل نوت بي افكتيف, او ام سوري ويل نوت بي افكتد باي ايج, بس ذا كلوزنج كاباسيتي ويل انكريز وذ ايج. ات ذا ايج اوف 44 if the patient in supine position, the closing capacity will be approximately على functional residual capacity. يعني واحد لما يصير عمره 44 سنة إذا كان نايم, طبعا لما تكون نايم أنت functional residual capacity راح تكون عندك إيش؟ أقل لهون مثلا, تمام؟ والclosing capacity راح تكون تقريبا على functional residual capacity. فالالفيولاي بيكون عندهم تندنسي إنهم يسكروا كتير وإنت نايم. لما توصل 66 year old, the closing capacity will be at the functional residual capacity or even more, okay, and even if the patient is in not supine sitting position. يعني حتى وهو واقف ال patient ال alveoli will be closed at the will above the functional residual capacity even if the patient is in sitting position. So this is the closing capacity. By this I end the talk about the